Please stand by for a priority communication from Supreme Chancellor Leontine Suresh of the Galactic Republic.
I apologize for contacting you outside normal channels, Major, but I need Havoc Squad immediately.
We're prepared to handle anything you need, Madam Chancellor. It'll be good to get back in the fight.
That's the spirit we'll need to triumph over our foes. And it appears we have a new one. The Hutt Cartel has invaded Republic space and seized the planet Makeb. We will respond to this unprovoked act of aggression in full force. My War Council will be convening on Keylander Station in the Makeb system. I ask that you join us immediately.
I'll set a course for the Makeb system right now.
Please hurry. We must act quickly and decisively against the Hutt's aggression.
Most cordial greetings. I am Zan Threlo, Republic Protocol Officer. Welcome to Makeb and Keylander Station. Please hold all questions. Supreme Chancellor Suresh and her delegation are arriving.
Everyone, this brave soldier assumed command of Havoc Squad in its darkest hour and led it to many victories. I regret that such heroism must remain classified.
Havoc Squad doesn't ask for fame, Madam Chancellor. It's enough for us to know the Republic is safe.
I want the galaxy to know you're a hero. People need them, especially now. Victory over the Empire lies within our grasp. But first, we must face a cowardly act of unwarranted aggression. Supreme Commander Malcolm.
13 days ago, the Hutt Cartel violated Republic space and seized the planet Makeb. They've blockaded the system with 30 Ajur-class heavy cruisers.
Makeb's citizens have formally pledged to join the Republic if we respond to their crisis. We will not abandon them to the Hutt's brutality.
Invading a planet is way beyond casinos and spice smuggling. The slugs have upped their game.
The Hutts haven't organized a military operation of this scale for millennia, and I want it to stay that way.
Severe atmospheric conditions on Makeb make large-scale troop landings impossible. We need help from local resistance forces to pull this off.
One of Makeb's business leaders, Shayla Mavesta, is awaiting you on the surface. I want you working closely with him.
I'm surprised the planet's army didn't put up a fight. Or did the Hutts defeat them?
Makeb's entire military strength came from hired mercenaries. The Hutts simply bought them off. Liberating Makeb is your top priority. But I want the Hutt's ambitions ended permanently. Grandmaster Satil Shan has insight regarding our enemy's future plans.
The Jedi Council has meditated on the cartel's actions. We believe that Makeb is a staging point for a larger attack on the entire galaxy.
The Hutts will not be allowed to expand their dominion at our expense.
If the Republic cuts a deal with the cartel, we could team up and take down the Empire together.
If there's to be any negotiation, I intend for it to be entirely one-sided. A shuttle will transport you to Shayla Mavesta's encampment on the surface. Go now, and show the galaxy the Republic is not to be trifled with.
Tropical antibacterials, check. Antivenoms, check.
You're one of the Republic heroes come to free my homeworld. You're just... wow. I wish we'd joined the Republic ages ago.
Your people could have joined us when the Sith Empire returned to the galaxy. What stopped you?
That was before my time, but we've always minded our own business and not gotten involved in other people's fights. Stupid, huh? I was here when the Hutts blocked all of Makeb's comm channels. Haven't been able to get a signal from my family since. No idea what's happened down there.
There's only one way to find out. Fire up that shuttle's engines.
Don't know if they told you, but McKeb's atmosphere's a real mess. Most ships get torn to bits by electrical storms on entry. My baby's got special ion shields to absorb the electromagnetic interference, but we're still in for a rough ride. Hopefully we won't land in little pieces.
How did the cartel conquer your planet if most ships can't even get through the atmosphere?
Our politicians figured, why draft an army when you can hire mercenaries? We bought the best. Bunch of hard cases called the Interstellar Regulators. But the Huts didn't bother fighting them. They bought off the Regulators with a bigger bid. Ask Shalem of Vesta. He'll tell you. My shuttle's prepped. Hop aboard and we'll be on our way. You might want to take your anti-nausea stims, too.
Welcome, Major. I'm Shalem of Vesta. The Supreme Chancellor pledged support, but the Elite Havoc Squad? It's an honor. My family helped found McKeb. The Vesta Mining has led our business council for decades. I was practically chief of state before the cartel's takeover. It wasn't an easy decision. But if joining the Republic is the only way to reclaim my home world's freedom, so be it.
We're your only chance of defeating the Huts. You either work with us, or take them on alone.
Forgive me if I sounded ungrateful. Of course we're happy to join your Republic. Ilosoth is a former mercenary with the Interstellar Regulators. Until recently, McKeb's trusted private army and police force.
Quit when the Regulators sold out to the Huts. I don't betray a client for credits.
Exceptions like him notwithstanding. The cartel bought off the Regulator forces, and turned our former protectors against us.
How many ex-mercenaries do you have on your side? Enough to take down the rest?
Regulators who refused the Hut buyout either ran or got shot for disloyalty before they could.
I still don't know why this has happened. We've conducted peaceful business with the Hut cartel for years.
Casualty and damage reports coming in. Talao City got rattled pretty hard, but no injuries. Lucky.
That's the fifth groundquake since the Hut's takeover. The last one leveled the Taigun mining colony. They're still pulling bodies from the rubble.
The Supreme Chancellor never said anything about groundquakes. Did you tell her about them?
I didn't think it was relevant. The tremors weren't notable. Not until recently, anyway. My niece Lemda is a respected geophysicist. She joined our resistance to prove there's a link between the groundquakes and the Hut's deep core mining.
She was taking seismic readings on a deserted mesa when a whole company of Regulators swarmed in. We've lost contact with her.
I sent search parties to bring Lemda back, but they aren't trained or equipped to fight a mercenary force of that size.
What kind of people are in these search parties? Are they at least armed?
The bulk of our forces are civilian volunteers. A few know how to fight. Most don't.
Getting reports from our search parties. Dozens of Regulators have pushed them back to the landing zone. We lose that, we'll never find Lemda.
We'll show those traitor mercenaries what real soldiers look like.
Don't underestimate them. A lot of Regulators are ex-military.
Take my personal shuttle to Fryn Mesa. Lane Farrow is our man at the landing zone.
Vehicle pads are currently open for business.
Shayla Mavesta sent us. You're in charge here?
Reinforcements. We're saved. Prosk! Havoc Squad's here!
Speak up, Lane. Not sure the whole Mesa heard you. My name's Prosk, in case Slick here didn't enunciate clearly. Kid's an accountant. Barely knows which way to point a blaster. Can't say I'm much better. Used to be a mining foreman. We've set up barricades, but they're not doing much against the regulators. What's the plan, boss?
What are we up against here? Have you seen the regulator forces?
There's a lot of them. They're mean and well-armed. We didn't introduce ourselves. Scouts report regulators headed this way. Big group.
Everyone's manning a barricade. Find one and dig in. The regulators didn't stand a chance against Havoc Squad, Major.
I'll drink to that, Slick. Those mercs will think twice about hitting us again. We owe you one.
You boys have any leads on Lemda, our missing geophysicist? She's the reason we're all here.
But her campsite was ransacked. The regulators must have already captured her and confiscated all the research data. Shalem's right. She found something important.
She might have escaped on foot before the mercenaries hit her camp.
Maybe. But then why hasn't she contacted us for help?
Scanners indicate no one except you has landed on or left the Mesa since the regulators came. That means she's still here. Probably at one of their camps.
Great. There's half a dozen camps and no way to pinpoint which one she's at. Have to keep hitting them until she turns up.
How big and well defended are those mercenary camps? I'm guessing our enemies aren't sitting around roasting bravolos and singing.
All we know is the regulators dropped a whole mess of men here with who knows what firepower. A few of our search parties never made it back. You find any other prisoners, send them here.
Someone here might know how to slice the regulators' comm frequency and find out what they're doing. Ask around, Prosk.
Slick takes charge with his big brain. On it, boss.
We'll hold this landing zone as long as it takes. Good luck.
Red Team, come in. This is Vice Commandant Grevin. We've scanned heavy fire in your zone. Status report.
That's a real fancy title, Grevin. Did you make it up yourself?
I command regulator forces on this whole hemisphere. You've got two choices. Surrender now, or die.
You're outnumbered by troops who have run ops in 30 systems. Our victory rate is 100%. You got lucky this time. It won't happen again. You should have taken the hint. I command the Regulators, and I've got plenty of reinforcements to throw your way. Now they're angry.
Whatever the Huts are paying, it's not enough. Quit while you're behind.
This op will be profitable long after you're gone.
It's Trosk, you read? We sliced the Merc's comm network. Hearing all kinds of interesting chatter. Whatever you're doing, it's paying off. The Mercs have pulled back. The landing zone's all ours.
Dig in and be ready in case they come back.
Understood. We'll keep listening to the Mercs' bellyache too. Might learn something we can use. Keep up the pressure.
Come in. We've taken out multiple Regulator camps. Still no sign of Lemda.
Scouts report you've got those mercenaries chasing their own tails. Lemda has to be nearby. I'll take some men out and cover more ground.
Think you're clever? Killing my people? Slicing our comm channel? Every time you hit us, the Huts crack down even harder on the nice people of Mekeb. They're dying because of you.
You're supposed to protect Mekeb. But you sold out to the Huts. How much are they paying you to execute innocent people?
Enough, obviously. Make your peace while you can.
Prosk, do you read? Another camp down and still no Lemda. Any luck on your end?
Hang on. Getting a distress call. It's her! Patching through!
Blast, is this stupid thing working? Hello? Hello?
We read you, Lemda. Your uncle sent a rescue team. The Republic's here, look!
Shalem didn't send more?
He told us you're a respected geophysicist. You look like a student. How old are you?
I received my doctorate 8 years ago. I was 16. Intimidated yet? My guards abandoned their posts and left me alone. You must be the murdering scum they went after. I broke free and ran to the nearest quake shelter. I'm the only person here. Sending you coordinates.
Don't move. The Mesa's crawling with regulators. Stay put and let us come get you.
I'm not setting foot out there. Wait, what was that noise? Is that on your end?
Lost her. They're blocking her signal. My team's close to that quake shelter. Meet you there.
A lot of my friends killed today. Grevin said I could return the favor.
Turn around. Slowly. This is a Republic world now, and that woman is a Republic citizen. Stand down, or you'll answer to me.
We're already earning enough from this job to retire. Once you're dead, we can do it in style.
The shelter's collapsing! We have to get out!
Don't do this. If this shelter collapses, we'll all be crushed.
You've got bigger problems!
There's never been a groundquake like that in Mekeb's history. Geologic instability has increased 1,000-fold since the Hutt takeover.
Seismic readings and core stability fluctuations both indicate impending catastrophe. These groundquakes are the direct result of Hutt deep core mining that's going to destroy Mekeb.
When you say destroy Mekeb, I assume that means more than your tourist trade.
The fireworks will be a great crowd pleaser, but only if the crowds are in orbit. Every scrap of data I collected here proves the Hutt cartel's deep drilling has destabilized Mekeb. These groundquakes are only the start. Entire mesas will collapse. After that, gravitational decay will strip away the atmosphere, kill everything. Mekeb will become totally uninhabitable.
If what you're saying is true, we need to get everyone off this planet right away.
We don't have enough transports to get everyone through the atmosphere in time. We need a real solution. I think there's a way to save Mekeb, but I need you to work with me. I'll warn you now. I'm snappish. Everyone says so. It's not personal.
I'd say you're handling yourself just fine under the circumstances.
My family is full of politicians. They say this is my way of rebelling. Did I mention I'm the one who convinced Uncle Shalem to contact the Republic? You're welcome.
You made it! We followed Prosk's signal and... Where's Prosk?
I'm sorry. He didn't. He's gone.
He gave his life saving Lemda. The best way to honor that sacrifice is by continuing the fight.
I know. I will. We'll get her back to Shalem. If there's a clear path back to the landing zone, thanks to you.
Meet me at Uncle Shalem's office. We need to figure out a plan. Fast. Nothing, Uncle. I've run the numbers. 2 days, maybe less. And your office is at the bottom of a sinkhole.
At least your expensive education has finally amounted to something.
Told you I'd repay that loan. Bet you're wishing you'd listened to me sooner, not dismissed me as a loudmouthed conservationist.
Major, welcome back. Lemda told me all about Havoc Squad's daring rescue. Thank you. We suspected McKeb was becoming unstable, but I had no idea things were this bad. We never should have let the Hutt cartel establish their mining operation.
You held back a lot of bad news, Shalem. Why didn't you tell us about the planet's instability?
I didn't want to cause a panic. The Keb's people must stand together. Only through unity can we overcome this crisis.
Know what doesn't help right now? Speeches. Unless I'm talking. The regulators who held me hostage were a chatty bunch. Mostly filthy language and bragging about their blasters, but the leader said something interesting. He mentioned Project Failsafe, a Hutt emergency plan if their mining went wrong. That mercenary believed the Hutts have something to instantly stabilize McKeb.
We can't count on Hutts to do the right thing. We need to seize that failsafe and put it to use immediately.
Glad you feel that way, because you need to steal it, assuming we can find it.
To Laos City, the Hutt Embassy database.
Ilasov's right. Data on Project Failsafe would be stored in the Hutt Embassy's computers in Talao City. Unfortunately, that's under cartel control. We need Chief Herquil, Talao City's former security commander. He and a few loyal men have a hidden camp outside the city. They'll get you inside the city and embassy.
Why is he hiding outside the city? Did he get fired as a security commander?
In a manner of speaking, the Hutts put a death mark on his head. The Hutts control Talao City and the surrounding area. They'll have to land a shuttle in the countryside. Expect plenty of regulators. Chief Herquil's camp is hidden at these coordinates.
Don't die. You're all we've got.
Welcome. Please select an available travel route.
Chief Herquil, Shalem Avesta sent us. He says you know a way into the Hutt Embassy.
It's an honor, Major. Forgive the smell, but I haven't seen a working shower since before the takeover. Hutt Embassy's locked up tight. Used to have a fancy-pants bureaucrat helping us inside, Representative Eklund, but he's gone quiet. Probably dead. Good news is, the cartel hasn't changed anything at their embassy. Got the same turrets, droids, passcodes I set up for them. Lazy Hutts.
If your intel's good, this'll be a walk in the park.
Walk might be generous, but your survival odds just went up to 50-50. You want inside the Hutt Embassy, you'll have to finesse three layers of security. First layer is heavy turrets in the courtyard. The only good thing to come out of these ground quakes is that they expose the turret power generators. Overload those, and turrets lose their punch.
Disable the turret power generator so we don't get torched on the way in. And then?
Security layer 2 is the embassy's main door. 3 meters of reinforced Durasteel. Even a lightsaber would take hours to cut through. But the door will unlock for a diplomatic passcode. You can generate one by accessing the government building secure terminal.
There have to be regulators on the street carrying passcodes. We'll be fighting them anyway, right?
Only top officers get into the embassy. You won't find them patrolling the streets. Last but not least are the security droids. Top-of-the-line Arcanian models. Nasty disposition. Shoot intruders on sight. Good news is, they can be reprogrammed. The droid control station in my old security HQ will do the trick.
We'll get the droids working for us. Smart thinking, Chief. We're on our way.
Hit those objectives, and I guarantee you'll get inside the embassy. Whether you'll find your answers is a different matter. If Representative Eklund's still alive, maybe help him escape? He's a fuss budget, but basically all right. I'll keep a comm channel open when I can.
Should take care of the security droids. code will open the embassy's main doors. The HUD embassy's all yours. Mind your step in there.
Acknowledging new ident code. Greetings, Senior Command Unit 223.
Here's another new command for you. Blast anyone who follows us through that door.
Acknowledged. Feel free to inspect the embassy. You will find everything in order.
Please, I'm an unarmed civilian, Representative Eklund with the Mekeb Provisional Authority Council. I'm the official liaison to the HUD cartel. Whatever you need, I'll make sure you get it. Just don't hurt me.
I'm Republic Special Forces, Havoc Squad. Shalem Avesta sent me.
That madman's gotten the Republic Army involved? Is he trying to start a war? Like it or not, the HUDs control Mekeb now. Our only option is to cooperate, make the best of our new situation. Instead, Shalem stirs up trouble. He doesn't realize how much worse the HUDs could make things for us.
The HUDs are bullies. Push them down and they'll back off. If not, they'll keep drilling into Mekeb until the planet cracks in half.
Cracks in half? Is that a technical term? It doesn't even make sense. The HUDs are here on the planet too. If Mekeb is destroyed, they die with it.
Geological readings show this planet is coming apart. But we think the HUDs have a project failsafe to deal with the situation.
Knowing Shalem, you'll risk anything to find it. Well, I'll save some lives and help quash this rumor for good. If this project failsafe exists, there must be some record of it in the embassy's archives. I'll get you access to them. But the HUDs are on high alert. They've already summoned reinforcements. You'll have to deal with them. I'll meet you in the archive room.
You're a HUD conspirator. I'm not letting you out of my sight.
You're mocked for death. I am not. If I die because I'm standing next to you when the shooting starts, you can't access the archives. And if Shalem's right, Mekeb will be truly doomed. I don't think you want that on your conscience. You worry about those reinforcements. I'll make sure we can access the HUD archives. Good luck!
Ah!
Security protocols have been disabled. Eklund came through.
Almost. I ran when I heard the fighting. Let me finish this. The hut in charge of Mekeb is named Taboro. If Project Failsafe exists, there should be some reference to it in his communication logs.
I assume you've met Taboro? What's your take on him?
He isn't your typical hut. Quick profits matter less to him than long-term gains. Here, a holo from someone named Vidrig has a Project Failsafe tag. Let's see what it says.
Greetings, O great and glorious Taboro. I'm happy to report that Project Failsafe is both on schedule and under budget. Your grand arc is approaching completion. As these schematics illustrate, the arc's ingenious outer layer will completely shield the vessel and its precious contents from Mekeb's atmospheric unpleasantness. The cargo hold will store your entire Isotope 5 stockpile, while your chosen few companions travel in luxurious comfort on the Ark's upper decks.
The Huts don't have a way to save Mekeb from breaking apart. They're just planning to leave the planet before that happens. You're on your own.
They'll abandon us? Leave everyone to die? That's monstrous!
Mighty Taboro, may I suggest replacing the standard passenger cabins with deluxe suites more suited to a hut of your stature? I can easily add them before the arc's completion.
This holo is recent. Vidrig is still building the arc. That means there's time to steal it for ourselves and evacuate the planet. Based on the schematics, we'll have room for the whole population if we convert the cargo hold to carry passengers.
There are only so many places the huts could hide such a massive project. We have to find it.
Evacuating this planet will require someone with resources and contacts. Shalem Avesta has both.
I'll scour these archives and transmit everything I find to Shalem. Given the circumstances, I feel rather unsafe remaining here. There's a shuttle pad nearby. If you remove the guards and unlock the shuttles, we could all fly away safely.